Good evening, councillors. Welcome to the annual meeting of the council, part two. I'd also like to extend a warm welcome to the members of the public in attendance. Please be seated. The first item of business, item one on your agenda, is declarations of interest. Councillors, you are asked to consider whether you have any disclosable pecuniary and or any other relevant interest in connection with any matters to be determined at this meeting, and if so, to declare it and state the nature of such an interest. May I remind you that you should state the item number and title and the nature of your interest. Declarations. Item two is Civic Mayor's announcements. I have been notified of the following apologies. Councillor Jeff Green, or any other apologies? Thank you. I would further like to congratulate and welcome all nine newly elected members and the 14 members successfully re-elected. And if I could, in the order as I see them, welcome the new members: Kate Cannon, Tony Cottier, Sam Frost, Sharon Jones, Liz Gray, Alan Brain, Mary Jordan, Andrew Gardner, and Tony Cox. Welcome. Tonight's meeting is being webcast. As you can see, temporary microphones are in use. There has been a delay in installation because the new microphones had to be specially commissioned for our chamber. It is expected that for our July meeting of council, the system, which will include electronic voting, will be fully operational. Following Tranmere Rovers' historic victory, invited to join the team at tomorrow evening's celebration reception. If you can make it, you are invited to arrive at Birkenhead Town Hall by 5:45 p.m. for a 6 p.m. start. The team will go out onto the balcony to meet their fans before the event closes at 7:30 p.m. Light refreshments will be provided. Please RSVP Dawn Kenner, in the Chief Executive's office as soon as possible, if you haven't already done so. Members should also be aware that there is a Tall Ships Civic event being held on Monday 28th of May 2018 from 11:30 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. in the Blue Lounge at the Floral Pavilion. Members must RSVP to Sue Carroll in the Civic Services Office by no later than Tuesday 22nd of May 2018, or they will not be catered for. I think there's a letter on all your seats. Now turning to item three, the minutes of the council meeting held on 19th of March 2018 are contained within pages 1 to 22 of the agenda. Pages 1 to 22. I will move approval of these minutes as a director. Do I have a second?
Second, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Williams. Are there any issues of accuracy in respect of the minutes? No, in that case, I will take the vote. All those in favour, please clearly indicate. Any against? Any abstentions? Petitions. Are there any petitions which councillors wish to present to the council in accordance with Standing Order 21? No petitions this evening? So, straight on to item 5, which are the election results from the 3rd of May 2018. Item 5 on the agenda, pages 23 and 24. Council is now requested to note the results of the 3rd of May 2018 local government elections. It's pages 23 and 24. Does the council agree to note the results?
Agree.
Thank you. Item 6, leaders' announcement. Now we move on to item 6, and I invite the leader of the council to confirm his cabinet and cabinet portfolio. So, Councillor Bill Davis.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd just like to take a few minutes to announce my cabinet for the forthcoming municipal year. I've got copies that members can take with them, but if I can just very briefly announce the portfolios and the portfolio holders. In no particular order, I'm establishing a specific portfolio for jobs and growth, which I'm asking Councillor Andrew Davis to take the lead on. That will focus on establishing the rural growth company and delivering the ambitious programme of regeneration that is in the train once the growth company is up and running. I'm establishing a portfolio around housing and planning, which I'm asking George Davis to take the lead on. That will focus on delivering our challenging targets around new housing and also completing the local plan. George will take the lead on that area. Third portfolio is a new portfolio around law and order. This is the agenda around building on the great partnership we have with the police and the other agencies around the Safer Wirral Hub. And I've asked a new colleague to join the cabinet this year, Councillor Paul Stewart, and I welcome Paul to the cabinet, and I know he'll do an excellent job in that portfolio. Highways and transport will continue to be Stuart Whittingham. There were some important priorities there around delivering the new programme of street lighting that we've got funding for, addressing some of the basic challenges we've got in street scene, and also ensuring that linking in with jobs and growth and housing, that we have good infrastructure links into our key housing and key employment sites. Leisure and recreation, I'm asking Councillor Phil Brightmore to take the lead on that area. That will focus on ensuring that our leisure facilities are placed on a sustainable financial footing, obviously in the context of declining resources over the next 2 or 3 years. On the environment, I'm asking Matthew Patrick to lead on that portfolio. Prior to that, we're delivering our target around recycling, 50% by 2020, and also continuing our approach to zero tolerance of littering and dog fouling. Next portfolio is financial resources. Janet Williamson will take the lead on that portfolio. That will be about delivering a balanced budget, which obviously, as we know, we legally have to, but that will very much focus on the three strands of our financial strategy: generating additional income for the council, reforming services and looking at new models of service delivery, and improving the performance of existing council services. And then we have our two social care portfolios, children and families. We ask Bernie Mooney to continue to do the excellent work she's been doing on that. That will be very much focusing on working at pace to deliver our improvement plan, and the overarching priority will be to move out of intervention as quickly as we can. And then adult care and health, Chris Jones will continue to lead on that. There is a very important programme around particularly issues to do with integrating health and social care. Both of these portfolios on children and adults, as we know, are very challenging in the sense that we have increasing demand and a very rapidly declining budget. And there will be particular emphasis on putting in place programmes around early intervention and prevention moving forward. And then finally, in terms of my portfolio, that will be around the overall strategic direction of the council, building the Wirral partnership, and leading Wirral across the city region. All of this, Mr. Member, all of these portfolios and the portfolio holders, this will be all done obviously within the context of the Wirral plan and the 20 pledges, which continues to be our guiding framework, which was agreed unanimously in the Mining Council in 2015. This will be year four of the five-year plan, so my cabinet and my administration, the emphasis will be very much on delivery. We've achieved a lot, I believe, but still a lot of work to do. And we still need to start thinking about the new plan post-2020, and we'll start doing that towards the end of this municipal year. So, Mr. Mayor, that's the cabinet and the portfolio holders in short. More detailed terms of reference for each of the portfolios and the portfolio descriptions will be published within the next few days, and that will be available to all members. That's my announcement. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Next item, item 7, matters requiring approval by the council. The council has been now turned to item 7, pages 25 to 68 of the agenda papers, which include reports on the appointment and constitution of council committees for 2018-19, appointments to statutory and advisory committees, working parties and families for 2018-19, appointments to outside bodies and organisations for 2018-19. Firstly, item A, on pages 25 to 44 of the agenda, the appointment and constitution of council committees. It's pages 25 to 44. I invite the Leader of the Council to move the recommendations in respect of the Constitution and membership of committees. Names of appointees to committees may be submitted to the Director of Government's Insurance by the respective political group leaders. Councillor Davis.
Yes, so moved, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Is there a second?
Second, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor George Davis. Are there any amendments to the proposal under Standing Order 12-1? In that case, all those in favour of the recommendations in respect to the appointment and constitution of the council committees for 2018-19, please clearly indicate. Those in favour? Any against? Any abstention? The recommendation is clearly carried. Moving on to our next item of business. The appointments to statutory advisory committees, working parties and panels for 2018-19, item 7b. I now invite the Leader of the Council to move the recommendations in respect of appointments to statutory advisory committees, working parties and panels for 2018-19, pages 45 to 54 of the agenda. Names of appointees may be submitted to the Director of Government's Insurance by the respective political group leaders. That's pages 45 to 54. Councillor Davis.
So moved, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Is there a seconder?
Second.
Councillor George Davis. Are there any amendments to be proposed under Standing Order 12-1? No. All those in favour of the recommendation in respect of appointments to statutory advisory committees, working parties and panels for 2018-19, please clearly indicate. Thank you. Any against? Abstaining. Recommendation is clearly carried. Now I invite the Leader of the Council to move its recommendation in respect of item 7c, appointments to outside bodies for 2018-19, on pages 55 to 68. Names of appointees may be submitted to the Director of Government's Insurance by the respective political group leaders. Councillor Davis.
So moved, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Is there a seconder?
Second.
Councillor George Davis. All those in favour of the recommendation in respect of appointments, sorry, are there any amendments to propose under Standing Order 12-1? In that case, all those in favour of the recommendation in respect of appointments to outside bodies 2018-19, please clearly indicate. Those in favour? Any against? I'm abstaining. The recommendation is clearly carried. Thank you. In that case, I can declare the meeting closed.